test on inside the atom. So here first question is the complete the following chart. So first question is the inside it here some atoms name are given, symbols are atomic number, electron number in the atom and electronic configurations, these columns are given. So first of all here it is the first that is a fluorine atom is there, symbol of fluorine is F, atomic number is 9, electron number in the atom. So for this how many electrons, so if its atomic number is 9 then how many electrons are there in it, 9 electrons are present in it, and its electronic configuration we have to write. So out of 9 2 will enter in the first orbit and then 9 minus 2 remains 7, so 7 will enter in the second orbit. So this is the number of, means how whatever is the atomic number, same number of electrons are present inside it, and electronic configuration is the 2 7. Okay, next atom is the chlorine, next is the chlorine. So here just now we seen that at number of electrons 9 and here 2 and 7. So chlorine, its a symbol is Cl, capital C and small l, atomic number is 17, so 17 electrons are there inside this, what, inside the electron of electrons are present in the atom. So 17 means first orbit inside 2 will enter from this 17, second orbit 8 and third orbit 7 electrons are present. So in this way its electronic configuration is there. Next third argon, its symbol is Ar, A capital and small r, atomic number is 18, so how many electrons it has, 18 electrons is present in the argon. So its electronic configuration is in first orbit 2, second orbit 8 and third orbit 8, means 2 plus 8 10, 10 plus 8 18. In this way this electrons will, what happens, enter in the different orbit. Next it is a neon, Ne for neon, its atomic number is 10, so how many electrons are there in it, 10 electrons are there, and then 10 electrons in first orbit inside 2 will enter and second orbit inside 8 will enter. So this is about this first question. So here you have to write a symbol, only the number of electrons, it's a number of electrons we have to write for this, not a what valence electron and all, depends on it. If all valence electron they are asking, the next column will come in the valence electron, and inside it its valency you have to write if it is there, but in this question I had not given to you. So valency is 1 for this, because 1 electron required to complete its octave, here also 1, here 0 and 0, because outermost orbits octave is completed. If they are asking then write this column, otherwise not necessary. Okay, now the next question, that is a complete the table inside isotopes I gave you here. Okay, as I told you the isotopes means what, the its chemical properties are the atomic number. So for isotopes, so isotopes means its atomic number is same, atomic number is same, but its mass number is different, and from this we can find out the how many, means protons and neutrons we are going to find inside it. So first it is the hydrogen, here 1 1 written, means this downside and here it is. So downside it is the atomic number, this is the atomic number, and upside it is atomic mass. Okay, so from this how to find out the atomic number of protons and neutrons. So how much is the atomic number, same numbers of protons are present inside it. Okay, and number of neutrons, so mass, atomic mass minus atomic number or number of protons, so we get it here, here upside 1 is there, so this is the atomic mass minus atomic number, so 1 minus number of protons is equals to how much, we will get it here, number of neutrons are 1 minus 1 is equals to 0, here it is 0 neutrons are present inside it. Okay, so here, so which formula we use it here, that is the atomic number, that sorry, so here which formula we use, A that is the atomic mass and Z that is the atomic number, and this is A and that is Z, so in that way means A minus Z is equals to what, we get it here 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. Now here these are the isotopes of hydrogen only, here how many protons are given, one proton is given. So its atomic number is same, but neutron it is present here, means one neutron it is increased. So here what will come? Here two neutrons will come. Two atomic mass is how much? Two. So two, how many protons are there? How much number of the atomic number is there? That much protons are present, and number of neutrons, that is the two here for this hydrogen. 2 minus 1 equals to how much it will be there? 1 is there, and that is already given here. This is a hydrogen, deuterium, and this is a tritium. These are the names I told you in my lecture when I took this. So hydrogen, that is the tritium. This is hydrogen, this is deuterium, and it is tritium. So here, if you see the atomic number, just I told you, it is not changing. So atomic number is not changing, that's why proton. So here it is A, and here what we have to write? Protons means A means only proton. That's why protons and A means downside number we have to write here. And neutrons are there. For that we are using the formula A minus Z is equal to number of neutrons. So here 1 is there. So here next for this tritium, 3 minus 1 is equal to how much? 2 is there. So here 2 is already written. In this way you have to complete this box. Next it is the isotopes. Here these are the isotopes of the hydrogen. In next question, the isotopes of carbon is given here. So carbon is given here. So for this, so here in this question I gave you carbon. In our textbook also carbon is given, but it is not the carbon, it is chlorine actually. So here you have to write the chlorine. Okay, so chlorine's atomic number is 17. So how many protons are there? 17 protons are there. And how many neutrons are there? We have to do the subtraction of this. Here it is 17, sorry, that's my mistake. So 35 minus 17, how much it is there? That is the 18 is the neutron number of neutrons are present in the chlorine. Okay, in our textbook page number 36 it is given wrong. All of you do the correction over it. Okay, and here for this the atomic, how much it is there? 37 minus 17 is equals to 2, means we have to do the subtraction of this is Z and this is A. So A minus Z is equal to 37 minus 17 is 20, and 35 minus 17 is equals to 18. Okay, so in this way you have to complete the chart. Now the next question is the write a short note on isotopes. So for this we have to move towards the textbook. So isotopes, the atomic number is the, so we have to write the short note on isotopes. The atomic number is a fundamental property of an element, and it's a chemical identity. But some elements in the nature have atoms with same atomic number. Their atomic numbers are same, but different mass numbers are there, and those are called as isotopes. Such atoms of same element having different mass number are called as isotopes. Okay, and here some examples are given. Carbon's isotope C12, C13, C14. It means that the isotopes also represented by the method. So here it is method shown by the carbon. Okay, and here it is the CR. In this PDF inside this is chlorine written, but in our textbook inside, if old copy it is there, then it is here carbon only written. So yes, this mistake was there in the question paper, that because of printing mistake it was happened. So all of you do the correction. Here it is chlorine, page number 36, some two students book inside carbon is given. Okay, now for the isotopes you have to write this short note and some examples. Now the next question is the which provision is made in the nuclear reactor to control the chain reaction. For that we will see the textbook. So here it is a picture, and here the provision, here it is given. See here, the following provision is made in the atomic reaction, means as you know that this is the chain reaction, means when this uranium atom is there, if it is bombarded with a neutron, it what happens? It forms krypton and the beryllium. Okay, atomic, its number of neutrons is here, one neutron added, then 135, it is 136 it was, and then what happens? Two elements are formed, that is the krypton and the beryllium, and here three neutrons form, and that again react with the uranium. again this reaction continuously going on, and this control of this reaction is very important. And for that the two methods are used. First method is the moderator we have to use. And which moderator? The graphite or the heavy water is the moderator used to reduce the speed of the neutron. And second, that is the controller to reduce the number of neutron by absorbing them. Rods of boron, cadmium, beryllium, etc. are used as a controller. So these two methods are there. We have to write for what purpose this provision is there, to control the chain reaction which is taking place in the what atomic reactor. Okay. After that question, we will move towards the next question, and the question number 4. Write the uses of isotopes. In our textbook, it is given in the box, blue color box on page number 37, the uses of this isotopes. So here it is our textbook, and here these are the uses of isotopes. Okay. So what are the uses of isotopes? Isotopes are some elements. Isotopes of some elements are radioactive, and they are used in various fields like industry, agriculture, medicine research field inside. So uranium-235 is used for nuclear fission and production of electricity. Some radioactive isotopes like cobalt-60 is used in the treatment of cancer. Second, iodine-131 is used in the treatment of goiter and different thyroid gland diseases are there. For that, some radioactive isotopes are used for detection of the cracks which are underground pipes inside. An example is sodium-24. Radioactive isotopes are used for food preservation from microbes, and again means potatoes are there, that is means radiations are bombarded on potato. Because of it, what happens, the sprouting we can control. And here some the radioactive isotope of C-14 is used to determine the age of the archaeological object. So these are the uses of the isotopes. That is the question I ask you in the paper. So here we have to draw the neat and label diagram of the electronic configuration or skeleton of here it is the question, skeleton of electronic configuration of sodium. And for this question we have to must know the sodium's atomic number, and its atomic number is the sodium's atomic number is the first of all I will drop this and then I will show you how to complete this. So first of all, the sodium atomic number of sodium is the how much? 11. Okay, so it has how many? So suppose this is the nucleus, then this is the first orbit, then this is the second orbit of the sodium. Okay, then how many protons are there? 11 protons. How many neutrons? 11 neutrons are present. And its electronic configuration, how it will be there? In first orbit 2 will go, second orbit 8, and last orbit 1 electrons will enter. So here it is, in first orbit how many electrons we have to show? 2 electrons. Second orbit 8 electrons. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and the 8. So this is the 8 electrons, and one more orbit we have to draw because it has 3 orbits, and for this is the third orbit. Okay, and in third orbit how many electrons are there? That is the 1 electron is present inside it. So in this way we have to draw this label diagram of sodium's electronic configuration. This question was half, means by mistake I sent it half only, option only not given. So in this way you have to complete the test. Okay, so today we will stop here only, and remaining means next test I will give you on composition of matter. Okay, tomorrow. Okay, thank you and have a good day.